Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we come together, let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthy magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So as we come together, let us sing our opening hymn, Lead Us, Heavenly Father, Lead Us. And sisters, as we come together to celebrate the presence of Christ here amongst us in word and sacrament, let us call to mind and confess our sins. So we pray together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Gives all who truly repent to have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and seated at the right hand of the Father, receive a prayer. Glory to God.
Image. Teach us to discern your hands in all your works and your likeness in all your children. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. So let us sit for our readings.
First reading is from the Old Testament, taken from Genesis. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created. In the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, when no plant of the field was yet in the earth, and no herb of the field had yet sprung up, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was no one to till the ground, but a stream would rise from the earth and water the whole face of the ground. Then the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being. And the Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east, and there he put the man whom he had formed. Out of the ground the Lord God made to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. The Lord God took the man and put him in the garden to till it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You may freely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall die." And the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all the cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And so we'll have our New Testament reading.
The New Testament reading is from Revelations chapter 4. "After this I looked, and there in heaven a door stood open, and the first voice which I had heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this. At once I was in the Spirit, and there in heaven stood a throne, with one seated on the throne. And the one seated there looked like a jasper and cornelian, and around the throne is a rainbow that looks like an emerald. Around the throne are 24 thrones, and seated on the thrones are 24 elders, dressed in white robes with golden crowns on their heads. Coming from the throne are flashes of lightning and rumblings and peals of thunder. And in front of the throne burn seven flaming torches, which are the seven spirits of God. And in front of the throne there is something like a sea of glass, like crystal. Around the throne and on each side of the throne are four living creatures, full of eyes in front and behind. The first living creature, like a lion. The second living creature, like an ox. The third living creature, with a face like a human face. And the fourth living creature, like a flying eagle. And the four living creatures, each of them with six wings, are full of eyes all around and inside. Day and night, without ceasing, they sing, "Holy, holy, holy, the Lord God, the Almighty, who was and is to come." And whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to the one who is seated on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall before the one who is seated on the throne and worship the one who lives forever and ever. They cast their crowns before the throne, singing, "You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you're able to sing our gospel hymn, "Make Me a Channel of Your Peace." Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. One day he got into a boat with his disciples, And he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side of the lake." So they put out, and whilst they were sailing, he fell asleep. A gale swept down on the lake, and the boat was filled with water, and they were in danger. They went to him and woke him, shouting, "Master, Master, we are perishing!" And he woke up and rebuked the wind and the raging waves, and they ceased, and there was a calm. He said to them, "Where is your faith?" They were amazed and afraid, and said to one another, "Who then is this that he commands even the wind and the water, and they obey him?" This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
So may I speak and may be heard in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please do be seated. I'm going to hold my hands up and say, I do not choose the readings. This gospel is clearly intended for the week we've just had, with the storm after storm, with the damage and destruction that has been wrought. But it's fascinating, isn't it, that actually we've got a really interesting set of readings this week. We start off in Genesis, all the way back at the beginning of the Bible, in this particular passage, an interpretation of how the world was created. Our New Testament reading comes from the very end of the Bible, Revelation, where John is describing what is to come and what will be. And we get this very small gospel, this middle section, looking at Jesus calming the storm and the disciples being in amazement. And he asks a very relevant and pertinent question: where is your faith? Where is your faith? Is your faith sat in this church here? Is your faith seeing what goes on outside? Is your faith knowing that there is good in other people? It's important we actually reflect and think, well, actually, you know, where do I get my nourishment from? Where do I get my strength of faith from? What helps me when I'm feeling rough, when I'm feeling low? These are important questions and things which we need to think about, actually, because we all have those times when we are rocked. We have those times when we are struggling, when we cannot always see the way through. St. John the Cross called it the dark night of the soul, when we are questioning of everything, when we are looking for Christ and looking for that reassurance, just as the disciples were looking for that help. Because when the winds and the rains were coming down, they didn't say, "Well, we're stuck, we're going to swim for it." They looked to Christ and said, "Lord, help us, or we are drowning." And Christ quells the storm, he rebukes the waves, and there is calm. Personally, for me, I find great spiritual nourishment in the Eucharist. I have done for a long time, actually, because it's about what Christ has done for us and will do for us. When we come to this altar, and actually, you know, this is not just because I get to be up here. Actually, whenever I receive communion, I recall and hear very strongly what Jesus has done for us, that his body was broken for us, that his blood was shed for us, and that through receiving of his body and his blood, I get that renewal of my connection with God and with Christ. But for different people, things are always different, and that's okay. So I'm not just saying that, you know, this is what I do, therefore I'm right and everybody else is wrong, but more that there are paths which we can choose. For some people, being in prayer and meditation is the best place for them to be nourished. For others, it is being within nature and unplugged from the rest of the world, actually be able to spend that quality time with God, which is most important. For others, it's being busy and working and helping other people that's most important. But it's good to know where we get our nourishment from. For some, it is being able to sing and rejoice with God. This is a good thing too. But we need to know how to recharge ourselves spiritually. If anybody of you had a long week and you've had a rough week, you say, you know what, just take the evening off, relax, have a bit of TV, go have an early night, and that's okay, and that's a good way to nourish ourselves, our physical bodies. But to nourish ourselves spiritually is a different matter entirely, but one which is just as important. Because you can be full of energy, but if your spirit is depleted, you can do very little good. And this is why coming together on a Sunday is so important. It's not just about being able to come and hear somebody read and hear somebody pray. It's about re-energizing ourselves. It's about coming together to get that oomph so we can keep on going. And it's important we find that place to have that oomph. It's important that we can renew and re-strengthen our connection with God. And actually, if we look at our Old Testament reading, we hear that God made man, made humans in his image. That's cool. That's really cool. We're made in the image of God. And to be fair, we look really, really different from one another. Which means actually it's not just talking about the outward physical fleshy bit, but actually that bit which we all have, that bit which is common across the board, which is our souls. Our souls are made in the image of God. Our souls cannot be nourished by good food or by company, but they can be nourished through our relationship with God. And so when I talk about actually how do we nourish ourselves spiritually, how do we re-energize ourselves spiritually, I'm talking about our souls. This is really important. We all need to know, where do I get my strength from? Where do I get the energy to carry on going, especially when things are tough? When things are easy, we don't normally think about it. When things are going along quite nicely, we don't need to worry. But we need to know how we keep ourselves energized, because it's so important. Because there will be times when we have those dark moments. There will be times when we do struggle. There will be times when we are so overwrought with everything that's going on. We need to know how to connect with God and what works best for us. Because if we can't do that, we will burn out. If we can't nourish ourselves both physically and spiritually, we will burn out. There's a meme that goes around on the internet very regularly, which is you cannot pour from an empty cup, and it will normally have an empty coffee cup, which is abhorrent in itself. But this is it. This is a genuine thing. If you are trying to sow love and care to other people, you need to show self-love and self-care first. Because if you are giving of yourself without looking after yourself, you'll soon become depleted. So I am. Sunday is a good day for me because I get to do preside at the Eucharist multiple times. I get to be re-energized and reconnect with God. Because actually, within the Eucharist, that is where I find my spiritual energy. And this is a very, very good thing. But you need to look and need to find where you're getting your spiritual energy from. You need to be able to say, actually, you know what? Going down by the river, because rivers are, actually, that's not a bad place. If you can't do the Eucharist, for me, river's a good place to be. Being able to spend time and just watch the river babbling along, to hear nature being, is a very good thing. But we need to find where it is. Seek it out, search it out, and when you've found it, make it part of your routine. Make it something which you do regularly so you can keep yourself energized and you can care for yourself. Because when we self-care, we can then care for others. But most importantly, find your spiritual nourishment. Find your connection with God. When you find it, hold it, love it, but love God above all. So may I invite you, as you're able, to please stand as we profess our faith and the faith of the whole church in the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So in the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to God the Father.
Love of such unfathomable depth, that you gave your Son for us, that we might live through him. Please help us to love one another, that you may live in us and us in you. We pray, Lord, that by your Holy Spirit we can live without fear, knowing that in everything you work for good in our lives. Please give us broad vision, that we can see beyond ourselves and walk in your light in every aspect of our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord, we pray for the Queen. We give thanks for her dedication to duty and ask that she would continue to be in good health and able to do everything she enjoys. We hold our royal family in your light and ask for your blessings and guidance as younger members of the family take increasing responsibility and prepare for the time when Prince Charles will be king. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Father, we pray for the worrying situation on the borders of Ukraine. May diplomacy and good judgment prevail on all sides so that conflict can be avoided. Please protect the people of Ukraine from war and all the resulting consequences of aggressive action. We also pray for the people of Russia and ask that their interests would be protected from President Putin's actions and ambitions. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all those who have suffered trauma and loss following the storm on Friday. We pray that our nation can do everything possible to counter the effects of climate change and prepare our infrastructure to withstand extreme weather. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the church, our bishops and clergy. We pray for Darcy and ask for your blessing on his ministry in Datchet and Colnbrook. Thank you, Father, that Jesus Christ is the vine. Help us to bear fruit both in our individual lives and as a church fellowship. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Father, we give thanks for the ongoing success of the bridge and pray for our annual general meeting tomorrow. Please help us, Lord, to continue to provide a village meeting place where everyone can feel welcomed. We pray for Sally Ann as she works on the spring edition of the Link. We give thanks for the Link and ask for your blessing upon it and all those who work on producing and distributing it. Dear Father, we give thanks for Andrew and the choir. Please be in their rehearsals and may all their music and singing be inspired by your Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
Hear our prayer.
Dear Father, we pray for all those we know who need healing. We think of all the children and young people who are suffering from mental illness and anxiety. We also pray for those who care for them. Help us, Lord, to be faithful in our prayers and minister to those who are suffering as Christ instructed his disciples to do. In a few moments of quiet, we pray for any friends, colleagues, or family members who need healing at this time. Dear Lord, thank you that we love because you first loved us. May all those we care for be blessed and experience the light of Christ in their lives. Lord, this morning we hold before you Dorothy Duffy, Mary Fitzgerald, Chris Allison, and Brian and Pamela Willison. Please bless them, Lord. Hold them in your light and love, and bring health and wholeness to them in mind, body, and soul. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have departed from this life. We pray for Vivian Dixon, Valerie Butler, and Margaret Whale. May their souls rest in peace. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
As you are able, would you please stand for the peace? Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, they should be called children of God." We meet in the name of Christ and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another just a sign of peace. Peace be with you. So we're going to sing our offertory hymn, which is Love Divine or Love Excelling.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, hear the prayers of your people as we celebrate this memorial of our salvation. May this sacrament of your love unite us more closely to you and to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. From sunrise to sunset this day is holy, for Christ has risen from the tomb and scattered the darkness of death with light that will not fade. This day the risen Lord walks with your gathered people. Unfold for us your word, and make yourself known in the breaking of the bread. And though the night will overtake this day, you summon us to live in endless light, the never-ceasing Sabbath of the Lord. And so with choirs of angels and with all the heavenly host, we proclaim your glory, and join in an unending song of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of heaven and light, heaven above all your glory, Hosanna, Hosanna.
Praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine upward may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son, who on the night before he died had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you. He gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with Our Lady, St. Thomas, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. rejoicing in God's new creation, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who call his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
The body of Christ. Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen. All are welcome to receive at this altar if you've already received in your home church or you've been confirmed. If you'd rather receive a blessing, if you'd like to cross your arms as an indication of your wish, they're much appreciated. Our routine currently is that we will peel off to the side, use the alcohol at the back, and then come to the front. And if you can wear a mask, that is much appreciated. Thank you. remain seated as we sing our post-communion hymn, Peace, Perfect Peace is the Gift of Christ our Lord. Set at the heart of the earthly paradise, and the bread of life at the heart of your church. May we who have been nourished by at your table on this on earth be transformed by the glory of the Saviour's cross and enjoy the delights of eternity through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we say together, you have opened to us the scriptures, O Christ, and you've made yourself known in the breaking of the bread. Abide with us, we pray, that blessed by your royal presence, we may walk with you all the days of our life, and at his end behold you in the glory of the eternal Trinity, one God for ever and ever. Amen. So notice there will be morning evening prayer Monday and Wednesday through Friday as per usual. On Wednesday at 11 o'clock we'll be having our midweek communion here, which you're all very welcome to join us for. Next Sunday is the last Sunday of the month, but it's going to be a bit different because we're having confirmation service. So we'll have AGM, BCP, Holy Communion at the side altar, as per usual. And at 9:30, we'll be having a joint service with St. Thomas's, but also we're going to be joined by folks from Horton Raisbury, as well as Upton Combe Chalvey, for all those who are going to be baptised and confirmed. So please do come and pray and support all those who are going to be confirmed next Sunday, and we'll also be having cake and various refreshments after the service as well. Two more notices for me, and I'm going to pass over to Marcina. One is palm crosses, which is nearly Ash Wednesday. So if you have any palm crosses lurking about in your house and you'd like them to be turned into ash for Ash Wednesday, please can you bring them back in? So we've got two Sundays to go before Ash Wednesday, so please dig them out, bring them next Sunday or the Sunday after. I can then make sure they're burnt in a suitable manner, ground up into ash, and then we will be placing them onto foreheads for our Ash Wednesday service, which will be at St. Thomas's. The other notice is that Living Love and Faith is still going on. It was very well attended last week. It was very fruitful discussions. Please do come if you'd like. Wednesday, 12 o'clock here for about an hour and a half, 2 hours, or St. Thomas in the evening at 7:30 for a couple of hours as well. So if you can join, there are links to the online site via Facebook and so on.
Just a reminder, last week I mentioned this World Day of Prayer, and it's going to be held this year on the 4th of March in the Catholic Church, St. Augustine's, in Eton Road. The theme this year will be England, Wales and Northern Ireland. And so there's the booklet, lots of lovely pictures of all of us. So this is Friday the 4th of March at 2:30 in the afternoon. It is a small church, so if you feel you want to go, fine. I'm sorry they don't have any refreshments. There's nobody to make them. So if you want to join us in the day of prayer, you're all welcome.
Brilliant. Thank you much. Having been to previous ones, they're always very good services and very worthwhile attending. Anybody else got any notices at all? Elaine shaking her head, Helen shaking her head, Andrew shaking their head. Fabulous, wonderful. In which case, we will stand and we will have the final blessing hymn and the dismissal. So would you please stand? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the Father, from whom every family in earth and heaven receives its name, put strength in you with his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. And the blessed God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. So we're going to sing our final hymn, You Shall Go Out With Joy. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.